Hey guys, it's Ruzerenee, and welcome to the very first episode of my brand new Let's Play. And you'll probably notice that there's no face cam for this episode. Feeling not too particularly photogenic today, so sorry about that. We've got my sim self in here anyway, so I think we're all good. If you don't know anything about this Let's Play, let me tell you a little bit about it. This is actually a remaster of an old Let's Play that I've got where I played through Discover University with a little twist. I've got a little bit of a Wheelspin to help me along. Help me or hinder me, I don't know. But yeah, basically the aim of the game is to see if I can get this girl, which is my sim self, to graduate from her university degree via Wheelspin. So I don't know if this is gonna be chaotic or if it's gonna be all right. I've made sims for my sim parents. They're not actually supposed to look like my parents, okay? They're very aptly named Papa Rain and Mama Rain, okay? So we're living in this apartment in San Myshuno, which I didn't honestly touch. I didn't modify really. I changed the wallpaper of like my Sim's room to purple because that's my favorite color. And of course my Sim dad is using my computer. Why? Yeah, so this is where my Sim and her parents live. Oh my gosh, I need to censor that on the TV. In terms of timelines, I imagine that my Sim self is probably just finished high school and is about to start the process of applying to universities and everything. In real life, okay, if you were a good student, you'd apply to universities before you actually graduate from high school. But this is a sim, so you can do whatever you want. So I think that you can go ahead and apply to a university through a computer. University, apply to universities. So for my sim self, I gave her a couple of skills that I would have in real life. And by skills, I mean I put like video gaming as number one. I've been gaming my whole life. I feel like I should at least give myself that. We've got video gaming at 4. We've got logic at 2. Writing at 2. I was in like higher level English literature in high school. I don't know if any of you guys have done the IB diploma. That's what I did in high school. Ruz is off sending her uni applications. What I wanted to do for today's episode, honestly, I don't want to go too crazy for the first episode. I just wanted to do a little bit of context building. I didn't want this to be like an entirely challenge LP kind of thing because I am using my sim self and I wanted to do something interesting with a little bit of story, a little bit of character development. My sim is right now just, you know, having a little bit of a talk with her parents about how she just sent off her application off to university. Like a lot of other high schoolers, she doesn't really know what she wants in life. She doesn't really know what university she wants to go to yet. They're both obviously fantastic universities, but she doesn't really have like a dream school in particular. And also, probably more concerning is that she doesn't have a particular degree that she really wants to go for. And the reason for that is because we're going to allow the wheel to decide. Now, if we're looking at our skills, I don't know, the best outcome probably would be like maybe a language literature degree or maybe a programming degree because we do have video gaming and logic. But if we end up spinning like biology or something, then we're spinning biology, okay? Oh, I should probably tell you guys about the little bio that I made for them. So here we've got over at the, I believe the arts corner. Arts quarter. Wow, yeah. Over here at the arts quarter is where myself and my sim family are living. I wrote down a quick little bio saying that the Rain family have lived comfortably in their San Myshuno apartment since forever. Things are about to change though as their only daughter, Ruz, that's me, has just sent off her uni applications and is set to leave anytime soon. Her parents want her to live in the uni dorms to live a complete uni experience, but it will be difficult to deal with a home that is one person emptier. You might notice on the left-hand side of the screen, we've got another family over here. I wanted to make a neighboring family to my sim family. So this is the Aziz family. So over here is Nyla Aziz, and she is basically Ruz's best friend. So Ruz is probably like, you know, gonna send a happy text over to her best friend. I sent off my applications to university, finally. Is gonna be an exciting thing. We'll see if her friend Nyla decides to say anything back. Well, hell yeah. It's a great day. Let's go out and enjoy the day. Oh, she is taking me to the Starbucks at 32nd. If you don't know, I built the Starbucks. Go ahead and download it on the gallery. You can find me there at ruzerenee. I also have an entire video about it. I'll show you guys the map of the world. I did put in a couple of buildings into the world to make it a little bit unique so that there are places for my sim to go to in case the wheel decides to spin and be like, oh, go hang out at this karaoke bar or something. So my friends, this is Ruzerenee's best friend, Nyla. Isn't she really pretty? I feel like I've been getting better at cast these days, but I don't know, you guys can tell me in the comments if I really have been. I think she looks cute. So here are the two friends. They've just met at Starbucks and they're probably just gonna hang out, honestly. Probably gonna hang out, catch up over a cup of coffee. Let's go ahead and order a drink. I'm actually sipping on a flat white right now, but it seems like there isn't such an option in the game. I guess a cafe latte would be the next best option. Please don't tell me that the game is bugging out. That is not what I'm into right now. Did my sim really just go inside the kitchen to order a coffee? Honestly, these girls don't have all day. They're just gonna go ahead and sit down and have a coffee together. No, why is this girl always here? Just go away. Go away. We don't want you here. Mila Munch. So Ruz is just catching up to Nyla about how she's sent off her uni applications and she's super excited but also super nervous about it, you know? I created Nyla's character to be a little bit opposite to Ruz's character in that she is actually not going to go to university, which I imagine is going to create a pretty big gap in their lives. The reason why she doesn't want to go to university is because, well, to be honest, she's not really interested in like being an academic. She kind of just wants to, you know, go and work and probably just work part-time while doing her own passion projects. So her character, I think I made her like a vegetarian, and one of her dreams and passions is to, you know, do something better for the world in terms of like climate change. And I think that in her gap year, she might go and do like some community projects or Lily Feng, we absolutely do not want you guys here. Stop, go away. But so yeah, they're at a little bit of a strange point in their friendship where, you know, they've known each other for a really long time, but now that university's come along, you know, their dreams are just, they're just different. You know, they've got different career interests, they've got different futures, so I don't know if they're gonna keep being friends for a long time. Because I think Nyla, she's probably interested in going over Evergreen Harbor, versus Ruz, who's probably going to go to Brightchester, and then when she's done, she's either gonna stay in Brightchester and be an academic, or she's gonna go back into San Myshuno and work there. Oh, I just forgot that she should probably go ahead and apply for some scholarships because we need the money. Her parents are not going to be giving her all of this money once she goes off into university, that's for sure. And by her parents, I mean me. I'm gonna give her a little bit of a challenge. So they've just finished hanging out, and I think that Ruz is feeling a little bit tense, not just because she's a loner and not just because that she needs to pee, but also it's just the fact that, you know, Nyla doesn't really get it. She doesn't really want to be an academic like Ruz. I think for Ruz, it's more like her parents really want her to succeed academically, and that's why she's going to university, versus Nyla and her family, you know, they're not really like pressuring her to do anything in particular. So after she's done using the bathroom, she's gonna go back home. Also, you guys, I'm filling up the world with a couple of builds. Friends over on Twitter might recognize a couple of these. These are from the hashtag newnewcresthoodis collab. Save file collab, which you should go definitely check out if you haven't seen these builds already. So Ruz has just returned home and it's starting to get a little bit dark. Her parents are actually outside. Where are they? Are they at work? No, they shouldn't be. Also, Papa Rain is a senior manager and Mama Rain is in the writing career as an advice columnist. I don't know why my sim has decided to cook mac and cheese, but you know, go you do you. I was gonna make like her mom cook a meal or something. Oh my god, why is Papa Rain cooking? He's gonna make a garden salad? Okay, you know what, you guys can make your own fancy dinner or whatever together. Aw, look at this father-daughter bonding time. How cute. For some reason, he didn't make like a batch of food for them. So that's unfortunate. You're gonna have to cook your own dinner. So I think that after she's done washing her dishes, I'm gonna make her apply to those scholarships. Oh yeah, let's email the former guidance counselor for advice on those scholarships. Okay, oh, so what did we learn? Ruz has the best chance of earning these scholarships. Education for all, San Myshuno resident, and esports. Okay, so all those years of video gaming probably, it benefits her in some way. So with that said, let's go and send out those scholarships. All right, so she's just applied for all three of those scholarships. So hopefully, you know, fingers crossed we get a good result in the next coming days or so. And her parents are here again, barging into the room as always. You know, honestly, Ruzerenee, you better work at that video gaming skill if you want that scholarship, like for real. So right now, Mama Rain is just trying to give her a little bit of a pep talk, being like, I know that you can do this. I think that's something that she's also going to say is that, hey, you know, you're gonna go to university now, you're gonna be independent, and, you know, your parents are not always gonna be there for you to give you, like, financial support. And so she's kind of nudging Ruz to, you know, think about maybe getting a part-time job while she's at university. And she's like, and Ruzerenee is like, yeah, okay, that sounds like a good idea. You know, a little bit of cash money is always a little bit useful here and there. And yeah, of course, Ruz being the very obedient only daughter is like, yeah, you know what, sure. I'll go do that tomorrow because it's a Sunday evening and she's not about to do that. She's relaxing. Everyone's gone away and to sleep. Uh-oh, turns out that Papa Rain can't quite sleep. Oh no, the whole family cannot sleep because the neighbors are too noisy. Honestly, if this were me in real life, I'd probably just try to ignore it and hope for the best that they would shut up. But maybe Mama Rain would like go over there and beat them up, pound on door and be a little bit assertive with what she wants. Ah, don't you guys just love city living? This is what I love about city living. The realism. The realism, you guys. You know, just going out in your pajamas and your little bunny slippers, trying to say a little word or two about your neighbors. Oh, and of course, Papa Rain is out here for a backup. Oh, it's this guy. What's his name? Salim Ben Ali. He's just one guy. Why would he be that noisy? What are you doing in there, my guy? I don't know what this Let's Play is turning into. So hopefully, you know, Mama Rain can sort this out so that her whole family can go to sleep. Oh, she actually managed to convince him. Oh, okay. 10 points to Mama Rain right there. He says, I'm sorry, you're right. That was a bit inconsiderate. We'll try to keep the noise down. Again, who's we? I know that you live alone. All right, well, he's gone. Let's go back to sleep. Or maybe Ruz can just keep playing until the sun rises. So the Rain family has had their beauty sleep. It's a Monday morning and the parents are about to go to work in a couple of hours. So I've woken up Papa Rain and he's gonna, you know, do his business, you know, really slowly. I think there's only one bathroom in this apartment, which is not really good. It's probably not a very good idea when you've got three people in the household. I think I'm gonna wake up Mama Rain as well so that maybe she can cook a little bit of a breakfast for everybody. So let's hope that Mama Rain doesn't, you know, bring down the whole house with her, with her amazing cooking skills. No, oh my god. Maybe it will wake up Rain. Maybe she'll come over and say hi to her mom. Good morning. Something smells great in the kitchen. What you cooking? You know, she's out here just like offering moral support. No, 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 we're not having this on episode one. Rain, Ruzerenee, please call the fire department. No, why does this always happen? No, Mama Rain, get out of there. She also has to go to work in an hour. Can you please call the fire freaking department? Oh my god. He's just running away. Is she gonna die? How could this go so wrong? How you were making eggs and toast. Also, you guys are absolutely freaking useless. I'm not shy of being willing to use some cheats in order to progress this Let's Play because I'm not about to have a death on the first episode, okay? Plus, I'm going to use the excuse of this game is buggy as an excuse to, you know, use cheats. So, yeah, you know, don't at me, don't fight me. Well, you can fight about in the comments below, but like, let me live my life, okay? It's my Let's Play. Anyway, the Sim family household received 222 simoleons as an insurance payment for the items that were damaged in the recent fire. Yeah, you guys, we're just gonna have cereal today. Oh my god, Papa Rit is pissed. Oh my god, no, she still has to go to work. Oh my god, I couldn't go to work like that. No. Oh no, oh no, no, no. bye. I'm probably just like, you know, this is like a really bad omen for starting university. This is like a sign that your life is about to be ruined, okay? We're gonna go look for that part-time job while we're waiting for university application. Gotta be useful in some way. So here are the available part-time careers for ruzerenee. Honestly, I think I'm just gonna let the wheel decide. So my friends, we've got our wheel spin here. First one of the day. Exciting. And we're gonna be choosing a part-time job for my sim self, ruzerenee. Let's go. Okay, she gonna be a barista. Okay, I'm honestly a fan of that because if you know me, you'll know that I'm an absolute coffee lover. I love coffee and one of my hobbies is actually home brewing. So you know what? Art imitates life. The wheel, it knows me. Maybe this isn't all going to be so bad after all. You know, at least we're gonna be doing something that that my sim is going to be interested in. Hopefully, maybe. All right, let's go back into the game. So the wheel has spoken and Ruz is going to be a barista. If you love hanging out at the coffee house and already know all the fancy drink names, why not get paid for it? This is how I feel. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and be a coffee stain remover. Unfortunately, can't choose a time slot, so I'm gonna have to wake up at 5 a.m. every morning. That's kind of rough. Actually, that's not even 5 a.m. every morning. That's probably like you have to wake up at 4 a.m. so I can get to work at 5 a.m. in the morning. That's rough. I can't imagine. Like, I'm a morning person, but 5 a.m. is too much for me. Ruz is probably like, you know, it's still some time until uni, so she's probably just gonna go hang out over at her friend's house, to be honest. So let's go over to her friend Nyla's house, which is just over the next quarter. So we've arrived over at Nyla's apartment. Hopefully they're home, but let's go ahead and knock over at their door. Oh, okay, I could just come on in. Oh, she is here. Oh, yay. I think that they're probably going to have a little bit more of a heart-to-heart conversation or the little blip and awkwardness that they had yesterday. You know, try to come to a little bit of an understanding, especially considering that her mom almost died. Her mom almost died, okay, so cut her some slack. So I think that while they're on the topic of university, one of the things that is important is checking out the campus. I don't know if you guys have done this before. When you're going into your university, you want to know, like, what in the world does the campus freaking look like? Of course, I couldn't do that in real life because that would mean going to a totally different country, so I had to do that through Google Maps. But these girls, they could just go over to Brightchester and, tour the unis there. So I think that Ruz is like telling her best friend Nyla, like, hey, do you want to come over with me? We're just gonna tour around the uni campuses a little bit, you know, so that when I finally get accepted into uni, I won't be totally lost. You never know when these two friends are gonna keep hanging out. It's like an important moment for them to bond a little bit more together. So here we are in Brightchester. You may notice that the map looks a little bit different from what it does in the vanilla game. So I've put in my build for the Fisher Library, a build that is inspired by my actual university library. I just dropped some builds from the gallery, to be honest with you. I think I dropped in this one, and this one as well. So I changed the commons as well as the Pepper's Pub. I remember that my university would have these like orientation weeks. I just remember the sheer amount of awe that I had when I went into university for the first time, you know, seeing the giant buildings and the campus is just like, wow. Yeah, I don't know about you guys, but let's just have a little bit of a Brightchester appreciation moment, okay? Like, look at those trees. How pretty is that? I love this spot, honestly. When you have your sim here ride around on a bike, I just like to watch some ride around on a bike, okay? So the two friends are just gonna, you know, casually explore the university library. Because they're just two curious little nerds. Oh, look at this little moment. I feel like Ruz is actually really happy to be here. Meanwhile, Nyla's just like, oh boy, you don't know what you're getting yourself into. So at this point, since she's not a student, I'm not gonna make her like touch any of these computers. She's probably just gonna have a little bit of a look around. I don't know if she can take pictures of the campus, you know, like a typical tourist. I don't know if this is gonna work. Is this gonna break my game or what? Oh, it actually works. Okay, now it's like 2 p.m. so they're probably gonna go and have a meal together or alone. I don't know. My game is super buggy right now and it's really bumming me out, not even gonna lie. But in real life, I actually did have ham and cheese sandwiches from these vending machines, not vending machines, these coffee shops out here. So this is, once again, very realistic for me. I was probably like, wow, this library is huge. It's kind of crazy. I don't know how you're gonna survive out here, Ruz. But, you know, good luck, because there's gonna be so much that you need to do. And I was like, I'm personally not gonna be cut out for it, but I guess you'll be fine. I think I'm gonna have Ruz check her application status, because I know that when I was waiting for my letter, I was checking it all the freaking time. Oh, okay. Oh, damn, okay. She's like on campus and then she gets her acceptance letter. Okay. Well, of course she got accepted into both universities. Oh no, Ruz was not accepted into any distinguished degrees at Foxbury, but she was accepted into a distinguished communications degree over at Brightchester. That doesn't necessarily mean that we're gonna be going for that communications degree, okay? We first need to decide which university we're gonna be going to. I feel like my girl would be very excited about that. If only that whole fire incident didn't just happen this morning. Okay, so what I'm gonna have these girls do is I'm gonna have to end their hangout a little bit earlier than expected, because they've got some stuff to do. I mean, by they, I mean Ruz has got some stuff to do. She's got some serious prep work to do now for her uni. But yay, she's feeling really happy. She's distinguished. Getting accepted into some distinguished degrees has made Ruz feel hopeful about her university experience. I'm happy for her, honestly. But also, again, there's no guarantee that she's actually going into that distinguished degree. I think that what she has to do, actually, is after she goes and showers, she has to actually enroll in a university. Actually, we should also check the application status for her scholarships. That would be important. Oh, Mama Rain has just come back home. Oh no, how is she? She's like, you know what? I survived today. I am a survivor. And I'm very proud of that. Meanwhile, Papa Rain is just like, God, you stink. So here we go. She's gonna go ahead and enroll. And we're probably gonna have to open up our wheel again. First major decision, alright, before we end part one, is which university are we gonna be going to? This is a big question. And only the wheel can answer. So obviously, we've only got two options for this, so it's just gonna be a 50-50 chance, either Foxbury or Brightchester. Let's go. I honestly don't have a preference. Ooh! Foxbury. Okay. Interesting, because in the first iteration of this Let's Play, I actually was also at Foxbury. So Foxbury is the newer university, the one that looks more modern. And I think that they're supposed to be more of a like technical university, more science-based or something, versus Brightchester, which is more, you know, liberal arts and fine arts focused. So these are the available degrees that Ruz can pick from. So we've got art history, communications, culinary arts, drama, fine art, history, language, and literature. So unfortunately, no distinguished degrees. The only one was at Brightchester and the wheel did not pick that. So we're gonna go back onto the wheel and pick out what degree she's gonna have. So I've once again updated the wheel with our seven options and hopefully it's something good. Let's go. Okay, communications. Honey, you probably could have taken a communications degree over at Brightchester, but the wheel did not want you to do that. Okay, how would we rationalize this? Maybe we would say that, you know, the distinguished degree over at Brightchester is probably heaps more expensive because it's like a special degree over there. So we're gonna go with the cheap broke girl option over at Foxbury University. All right, so I actually don't know anything about the communications degree in this game. So I'm gonna actually read this. To understand one another, we must first learn how to communicate with one another. True. With an emphasis on building the charisma, writing, and logic skills, the communications degree is a big help to anyone looking to work effectively in a professional environment. The degree allows for entering at a mid-level with signing bonus for the following careers: charity organizer, civic planner, journalist, management, and public relations. Honestly, I had no idea about that. That's actually a lot of options. So the very last thing that I want to wheel spin for my girl Ruz is the number of classes that she is going to be taking for this semester. It's a minimum of one and a maximum of four. Four classes is a lot to deal with. It is a lot, especially if you have other things like organizations and part-time jobs and, you know, a wheel spin to ruin your day. So if you've got four classes plus balancing the rest of your Sims life, you're not gonna do it. You're not gonna do well. At least that was my experience. It was really hard to balance. 1 to 4, here we go. No! No! I'm gonna cry. I can already feel the pain. Here's to a rough first year for you, Ruz. We're gonna go have 4 classes. We do know that she's going to be going to uni dorms. Am I really gonna let there be a wheel spin for this one too? Ruz, your life is completely out of your control. It's all in the wheel, okay? So now we're basically going to be wheel spinning how much money our girl is gonna be paying for her dorms each semester. So let's go. Oh, okay. A tower. Tower means cheaper, which is good. So the wheel has spoken and it has chosen Briny Tower as her dorm. If you're not aware of my original LP, I actually stayed in Tidal Tower. I did install a mod for the roommate system, and you're going to be seeing all of the characters that I made in my cast video in the next episode. But for now, we're gonna go off. Oh boy, with all 4 of our core classes, I can feel the pain. Oh, did we get any scholarships? Oh no. Oh no, we didn't get any scholarships. Oh no. Oh, well, here we go. I don't think that she's gonna be having that much money. Let's return like 2k. There we go. Well, my friends, I think that that is going to conclude the very first episode of my remastered university Wheelspin LP. Thank you guys so much for watching. So if you're not aware, I've changed my upload schedule to just once a week, every Wednesday, because my schedule has been getting a little bit crazy. Hopefully I will get back to a 2 times a week schedule, maybe when my degree ends. I don't know. My degree in real life, by the way, not my degree in The Sims. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.